People deluded, I'm back again. Excuse my poor handwriting, and I'm not sure if you can see this, but yeah, it don't make sense at the moment, and it does definitely doesn't make sense when you have handwriting like me. But basically, you lot know I love young players, and I want them all to make it, but how feasible is it? I've specifically looked at our attacking options, the midfield cam sort of thing, so yeah. You've got to look at it, is how feasible is it for these young players to really get substantial game time at the club to make it here? And to be honest, this is why I say young players should sign themselves and go somewhere where they're genuinely going to play. Because let's take this. If we look at, I'll just talk you through it. But if you look at these three, you've got right wing, you've got left wing, you've got central, yeah? Look at all of the options I've got here. Ignore this bottom, I'll explain that. But if we look at left wing, now, I've put couple players, the young players, in a couple positions I've seen them in, innit? Like, obviously, for me, Emil can play on both flanks, but he looks like he's going to be the 10, the mavericky sort of player when he's older. Nelson can play 10. He's clearly a winger, for example. And so, use your brain, innit? We've got players that can play everywhere. But if you look at it, if you look at it, for on the right wing, for Nelson, Emil, Saka, Emichi, that's four of them already fighting for that one position. Do you get it, people? Between themselves. And then, obviously, Arsenal need a winger. So, you could say we might bring one in the summer. You've obviously got Mkhitaryan, who's excelling there. Awobi predominantly plays on the left, but could be played on the right. And would probably be used them before these lot are used. Hope to be wrong. You've got Denis Suarez as well, who could be used out there. Do you get it, people? So, that's about four or five names already. Four or five experienced players that these isolated players are going to have to fight against. So if you're Amici, I feel Amici is the one that needs chances this year, really and truly. But if you're Amici and you're fighting against Nelson, who's another direct right winger, maybe Emil and Saka if they're put out there, which they can do, then you've got Iwobi, Mkhitaryan, a new winger, and Denis Suarez. So how feasible is it that you're going to get substantial game time if the manager doesn't take a liking to you? If you look at the 10 position, more Emil stuff. On paper, Ozil is still here, but he's 30 and he might be moved on in the summer. Mkhitaryan is contracted until 2021, so there's always the option of loaning these players out, getting some experience and coming back in. But at the moment, Mkhitaryan is here and playing quite well. Obviously not in this position, but he can be used there. It will be long-term. This is his thing for me anyways. He can be used there. Denis Suarez, probably where he's more confident. Joe Willock at a point, probably deeper, but can be used there. And again, we have to remember we could bring in another midfielder. Do you see what I'm saying, people? I haven't included Ramsey, but for this year it's at least, or to the season ends, you could say Ramsey. So you see the amount of competition. How feasible is it? There's 38 games in the Premier League. All the other cup competitions, you can be specific if you want. How feasible is it for these young players to stay at these clubs? How many minutes are you going to get to develop? Because I always say these young players, they need 10 games. I'm not saying they must start game in, game out, but that's where you get a judge of where they're at in terms of senior level. Because there'll be games, Amici, Nelson and that, boss it, score 10 goals and that. There'll be games where they're anonymous. There'll be games where they're so-so. Because that's nothing to do with them. They're still trying to get consistency. But to learn, to get experience, like a lot of people in working life, away from football, see in my generation, to get experience, you need to be given a chance. And sorry, people for shaking the screen. How feasible is it with all of these players that are in it, with all the dynamics of play at the first team and needing to get back in the Champions League? On the left wing again, Emil, Nelson, Saka, Amici are all fighting with each other and they can all play there. But that's it, will be nailed on. Denis Suarez hasn't had a look in, but he'll probably play there before them. A new winger, etc. as well. So you see how much competition there is for places, people. In my opinion, Emil Smith Rowe will go out on loan next summer. I want all these kids to stay and give them chances, but I think he'll get a taste of the Leipzig stuff and he'll go on loan again. I'd love him to stay and be used with all the departures that look to be incoming. But if you're not going to get guaranteed games, that's where he needs to go. And obviously, it's a bit different because I haven't talked about defenders, but Mavropanos, if he isn't going to be given a fair shot at games, he needs to go on loan as well and get some top-level experience. I've said Nelson. Saka, I think he's a bit younger. He's going to be what? He's technically a first-year scholar, forgive me if I'm wrong. He'll be second year next year, such as his progress, forgive me if I'm wrong. So he's not in any rush, but you've got to look at the pathway. He's badding up under 23, so eventually if he feels he wants to test himself, where is it? Obviously, Unai Emery is giving him his Prem debut and he's played Europa and he's had a look in, but you get the point, people. that's where I say at times there needs to be a pathway, and there needs to be patience, but there also needs to be a pathway, and it also comes down to brave decisions from the club. Are you going to give chances? Do you see what I'm saying? If we talk about the strikers, Balogun, John Jules and Eddie Nketiah are fighting each other to be the young player on the thinking, on the thoughts of Unai Emery, but they're going against Aubameyang and Lacazette. Now, Aubameyang in particular, he's, what, a year or two older than Lacazette? So they're getting on a bit, but you're probably looking at a year or two on loan before you're given a fair crack. Now, these lot can get minutes, can be the first-choice striker, can get minutes in the cup, and I'm sure they'll relish it. But you've got to look at it. Balogun signed a new deal. He's playing at under-18s at the moment, getting minutes for under-23s. If you was to ask me who was the first-choice at under-23 level, it's Eddie Nketiah. But he's at that level, he's basically first team now, so he's flying out. When he's not there, it's Tyrese John-Jules. And then obviously there's Balogun, and you've got Greenwood behind him, so you can see the pathway. So these three are fighting each other to get into that first team, and then they're fighting two other strikers. So if you're Balogun, who I think would be, not because of ability, just one based on what I'm seeing, people, last in the pecking order, you've got Balogun's here, people, but you've got John Jules, you've got Eddie, you've got Aubameyang, you've got Lacazette. And if, to be honest, these young players, I feel these young strikers, they can get minutes on the flank. So you've got a whole leap of players, isn't it? So do you see how I'm going, people? And most of these players are 17, 18, 19. When you're 19, at a push 20 in some cases, you don't want to be playing under 23 football. And if you are, there's an issue. You shouldn't want to. You should want to progress. So that's why it's not really feasible, as much as I want it to happen, for 5 or 6 or 7 of these young players to make it at this club or at any club. Look at United with Greenwood, Chong, Garner, Levitt. They've got some bad boy footballers. I hope to be proven wrong. I want to be. I want all of these young players to progress at any team. But there's serious dynamics at play at football. And when you look at it, how feasible is it? Again, I go to all these games and all these things. Nobody wants these young players to progress more than me, but how feasible is it? And this is why I say these young players, they have a duty to sign themselves. I get it. If you've been at Arsenal as an Arsenal fan, or Chelsea as a Chelsea fan, or whatever, if you're a fan of the club, you've been there for time, you feel comfortable, I get it, you want to make it here, but at times you need to look away from that dream and remember the real dream, or the actual goal, end goal, is a professional footballer, earning a living, playing in a top league and just progressing. And I don't feel that's the case of many of the top six clubs and just academies in general, to be fair with you. Hopefully when you see it illustrated as something like that, all the way I've talked it through, you can kind of get the points I've made. I think I've actually today made a similar vid along these lines, but apologies if I haven't given you any other content that you like. But on that note, I'm going to keep it pushing, people. People, deluded, comment, subscribe, and the rest if you wish.